Hi, I'm Dee.
And I'm Sue, and here we are, GOATchat.
What was your favorite non-championship WNBA team you've ever been on?
Good one. I would say our team in 2016. Mm-hmm. Part of me thinks, like, some of my answers, like, if you were to say favorite team right now, I would have said 2018. Sometimes right. It's like, it's just fresh.
Right.
So I'm sure there's some other ones, so this is like no disrespect. But the 2016, it was one of those teams where Stewie was a rookie. Mm-hmm. We had just come off not making the playoffs, yada, yada, yada. And we didn't really have that many expectations, and we made the playoffs. Right. So it was just one of those seasons where it's like nobody expects a lot of you, and all of a sudden you're kind of like surprising mm-hmm. some people, you're getting into a groove. And it was another one of those seasons where even though, I mean, I'm sure if we looked up our record, who knows, we're probably 500. Mm-hmm. It's not like we didn't exceed expectations by that much.
Right.
But even at 500, even in losses, we felt good. Mm-hmm. We're like, hey, we're playing well, we're maximizing what we can maximize right now. And so every time we walked off the floor, win or lose, we felt good about it because we knew we were kind of going somewhere like long term. So that was one of my favorite seasons. Yeah. At the end, we actually all got these t-shirts. They were the Golden Girls, but it says Squad Goals on it. It was like our team t-shirt. It was just like one of those years.
Yeah.
Everything just like vibed.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a good year. What has been the highlight of your career thus far?
Oh, God. I think we've been pretty lucky in having a lot of moments. I always say it was game 5, 2009 at home. To win a championship at home is just the best feeling for your fans. So I would say that game.
Yeah, that was a good game.
Yeah. What has been the most challenging part of being a professional basketball player?
I was going to ask you that next. Probably like missing moments in your friends, families, like that part, mm-hmm. you know, like if you're overseas, you know, maybe you miss a birthday or a wedding. I mean, so many weddings mm-hmm. I missed. I missed my first niece being born. I didn't get to meet her till like a month or so mm-hmm. later. Just things like that. Yeah. I think that's like you can talk about the hard things that happen on the court. Those are challenging. I'm not trying to like put those like they're not. They mm-hmm. are. But I think like at the end of the day, it's like you miss these moments.
Yeah. And you can never get them back.
You can never get them back.
Yeah, I remember coming back from Russia one year and I was having dinner with my parents and I just kind of randomly look up and nothing really special happened, but I look up and I was like, wow, my parents are getting really old and I've missed so many moments. And I look over and my nephew's 7 and you say, you miss birthdays and just random weekends when you can just hang out with your family.
Yeah.
Where, you know, when you're gone a lot, like we have, like everything has to be like a special occasion, like, you know, dinner special.
Oh, my friends, are you kidding? Sue's last night in the city. Yeah, it's always, like, hey guys, you gotta come out. It's Sue's last night in the city.
Yeah.
And it happens like every time I'm around. It's actually a joke now. we celebrate it even when it's not my last night. When you're done playing in the WNBA, mm-hmm. what do you want people to remember most about you?
Hopefully that I was a good teammate. You know, and I gave everything to the game of basketball, to whatever team I was on at that specific time. I want people to think that I was a good teammate, that I wasn't selfish, that I always put the team...
Not the spitting? You don't want them?
The spitting, when would that happen?
Oh, you don't remember that part?
Mm-mm. So it would definitely be how great of a teammate I am. And
I thought you were going to hit us with some like Frank Sinatra. I did it.
No. You know, I've conformed to the rules of this league for many years and, you know, it's just beat me down to just being grateful.
Okay. Good answer.
Thank you. Sue, I have a quick question for you. What does the perfect life post-WNBA look like for you?
I think I'm going to need like a year of detox, maybe more, to be honest. Maybe somewhere on a beach, living off the land.
Mm.
You know, probably won't happen, but that would be ideal.
Off the grid sounds good.
Yeah, off the grid for a while.
Sounds great.
I can't see that actually happening, but it'd be nice.
No. I know. Every time I get that question, I'm like, oh, I'll do the same thing. I'll take an island. I'll take seclusion, and then like a week later, I'm gonna need.
You're gonna make like, I would say 10 minutes, and you're gonna be like.
I am. Where are we going? What are we doing?
Yeah.
I
give
Let's
you 10
dribble.
Minutes max. All right, y'all, that was it. This was some goat chat, some goats chatting.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks for tuning in.